One of the most commonly asked questions in screen printing is, how do I color separate in Adobe Illustrator? In a word, spot color. Well, technically that's two words. As long as you are working with and designing with spot colors, your design is already color separated. So that begs the question, what's a spot color? How do I find or create a spot color in Adobe Illustrator? Well, before that, let's talk about CMYK and what it actually looks like. We're going to walk through the two designs I have here and break them down. On the right, this design is in a CMYK build. This means that I will only be able to press the CMYK button for separations. I am unable to create individual colors with this design the way it is. On the left, I have the same design with a spot color build and minor color changes. In this window called Separation Preview, you can see the spot colors listed out. This design has no CMYK color in it, and when I need to make my film positives, they will print out properly as individual colors when I send it through RIP software. So back to the question of how do we create a spot color? To create a spot color, first we want to create a color swatch. We will do this with a color selection of the goldfish here on the right. We will use the white selection tool from the toolbar. Click an orange section of the goldfish. That gold color then shows up here in our toolbar window. Drag this color to the swatch panel. Double click the color and go up to color type and click the drop down menu. Choose spot color and then give it a name. Let's call this one Marmalade Jam. Your color swatch will now be recognized by Illustrator as being completely separate from all CMYK separations, as CMYK is the default for Adobe Illustrator. You can also now see that the spot color, Marmalade Jam, has just shown up here in the separation preview window. So what do CMYK and spot color separations look like? To show you this in action, we will first need to be in the CMYK color mode, and then we will use the separation preview window. When I click Overprint Preview, the background color will change as a way to isolate the design you are working with. On the top, you can see CMYK, and under the black, you can see the beginning of my spot colors, including the one we just created. As we turn on and off the CMYK eyeballs, you can also see the color turn on and off in the design on the right. Let's take a look at the spot colors by turning on each color. As you can see, each color shows up individually. No CMYK builds here. This design is ready to be printed out as film positives. Since we have already started the conversion of the fish on the right to spot color, let's make sure all of the orange shade is now a spot color. I'm going to turn off Overprint Preview so we can see that fish. Again, we will select the CMYK color of that orange. Click anywhere on the fish where that orange is. Go up under Select, Same, Fill Color. This now has selected everything in the design that is that CMYK color build. Now, in order to change all this to a spot color, simply click your spot color, the one that we made called Marmalade Jam. Now to confirm all of the orange has become a spot color, let's turn on and off the eyeball in separation preview. So we'll have to turn on Overprint Preview. Let's turn off our already separated spot color design and then turn on the Marmalade Jam. Now to confirm again that all of this has been converted, let's turn on the CMYK and turn off the Marmalade Jam. You can see that all of the CMYK build for that orange color is now gone. It no longer exists in a CMYK format. It's now a spot color. Another way to confirm the switch to a spot color is to change the color like this. This is a quick way to confirm you have grabbed all the individual bits of color. We're just going to make a color change. Let's not save this so it returns the original color and continue on with converting the rest of the design. So now we'll go through and we'll pick the other three colors that are in the design. First one, we're going to pick the light gray. We're going to do all of this in one step. We're going to go up under Select, Same, Fill Color. Everything here has now been selected. It is still selected. We will double click this, make it a spot color. And for the sake of this video, I'm not going to change this swatch name. I'm going to leave it as that CMYK build and then click OK. We can see that it has been added here to our swatch window in the separations preview. The next color is going to be this navy shade. Let's confirm that it is navy. Yep, that's a navy. And again, just to make sure we've got all of it, we're going to go up under Select, Same, Fill Color. And it's selecting everything as a fill color. So now, drag this down, double click, spot color. Let's go ahead and give this one name, navy. Click OK, click off. Let's confirm that we got everything. Do a big color tweak on it. Looks good. Click cancel so it does not save. And there's one more in here. There's a black. Select, Same, Fill Color. Looks like that's the only one. We're gonna take this, drag it over. I'm gonna double click this. Now black is a special case. We can name this a spot color, but we can't actually call this black. In fact, let's go ahead and make this maximum for the color values. We can even convert this to RGB and again have maximum for the color values. Now we can't use the name black because black is reserved for CMYK. So we're going to call this spot black. You can actually name it anything you name. Oh, spot black is already in use. Oh, that's right. It's right there. So I can't use that name. You can't use the same name twice. So let's call it halftone black. Doesn't matter. You can even call it black M, C, B, doesn't matter. Click OK. Now, this is the way, this is a final test. We're going to click Overprint Preview. Turn off our spot colors. Oop, that black would. There is absolutely no CMYK left in this design. So if we turn off the CMYK eyeballs, now we'll be able to see the entirety of that design. That is now a spot color build. That design is now ready to be sent through RIP software so you can get your film positives. Let's take a look at the design that I already had here on the left. To recap what we did here, this is the teal that we called out, the orange that we called out, that shadowy color that you can see there underneath the, in the bottom of the goldfish, where we'd used a pearl and a little bit of that teal color to give it a watery texture. Basic Illustrator separations are as easy as creating spot color. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in learning more about color separations, watch our full course on screenprinting.com, where we will dive into spot color, color reduction, index, grayscale, and the always popular CMYK process.